2,250 words. I estimate that the average Netflix show has 50 words per minute, which equals 2,250 words in a 45-minute episode of your favorite show. That's a lot of chances to learn new words. Hello, language learners. Today, we're going to learn some new words using the Netflix series Narcos México, the popular series about the drug war in 1980s Mexico. And to do this, we're going to play a language learning vocabulary game I came up with to learn new words using Netflix in Spanish. You can play this game with any other show and for any other language, as long as the show has subtitles or audio in the language you're learning. But we're going to do Spanish in this video as an example. Here's how the game works. First, watch through an episode of Narcos Mexico for the first time. Start on whatever episode you're at. The exact episode you watched doesn't really matter for this game. I haven't started the show yet, so I'll be starting on episode 1, but start from wherever you're at. 2. Whenever you come across a word or phrase you don't know, write it down. And you're going to get points for these later, so find as many new words and phrases as you can. 3. Every 10 minutes will be a different round. So divide your paper into separate sections for minutes 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, and so on. And 4, at the end of each round, or you can wait to finish all the rounds, it's up to you, go back and find out what all the phrases you wrote down mean, and then give each phrase a score using this point system. If you found the meaning of your phrase on Google Translate or guessed it yourself, give that phrase 1 point. If you couldn't guess the phrase, couldn't find it on Google Translate, but you found it on some other part of the internet, give that phrase 3 points. And if you couldn't find the phrase anywhere on the internet, or it wasn't clear and there's a lot of confusing definitions, give that word 5 points and circle it. These 5-point words have a bonus challenge. Either send these words to a friend who speaks Spanish to ask them what they mean, or add these words into the comments to crowdsource from the YouTube community. If you do either of those challenges, take the word's value from 5 points and bump it up to 7 points for completing the challenge. Alright, now that we have the rule set, let's dive into round 1, enjoy seeing Narcos Mexico, and learn some Spanish while doing it. Round 1, vamos al lío. Alright, here's some fun facts about Narcos México. Got 3 seasons with about 30 episodes total and premiered in 2018. There's another show, Narcos, which is older than Narcos México. Narcos México was actually originally supposed to be the 4th season of Narcos, but they decided to spin Narcos México into its own show. The original Narcos is about the Colombian illegal drug trade, while this show focuses on Mexico. Just like any show, watch it and enjoy the story, but please don't assume that it represents the country or culture. Enjoy it, but realize it's a tiny blip in the larger story of these countries. The first 10 minutes is done, round 1 is finished, here are my results. I found 6 words for 10 points. First was bocina, which is car horn. Then was el caudal, which means the fortune. Then we had adormideras, which are poppies.
With its fertile fields, hills heavy with opium poppies.
We also had fumetas, which are stoners.
To potheads, and the Sinaloan scumbags who operated there.
Then was the phrase vuelale, which I'm pretty sure means step on it or run.
Vuelale, Rafa.
And finally, buen jale, which is good work.
Buen jale, comandante.
Okay, that's round 1 in the bag. Let us know in the comments if you beat my score, and let's dive into round 2.
Let's get it with round 2.
Pegaste bien recio, pendejo.
Sea llorón.
In round 2, I got 10 words for 12 points. First was plantillos, which means plantations. Then was cerro, which means hill. Then desbaratar, which is to destroy. Then was sesos, which means brains. Then recio, which is tough or intense. Then was policiaca, which means relating to police.
Pudiste haber tenido una verdadera carrera policiaca, Miguel.
Then fardo, which is bail.
You take me to your warehouse. You pull out a bail.
Then we had prepotente, which means strong or predominant.
Noah, what kind of pushy, man?
then calada, which means to take a hit, puff, or smoke.
Why don't you take a hit? Chill,
let's go. And finally, tira, which means cop. So that's 10 words and 12 points. Let us know if you beat that score in the comments as well. All right, I'm gonna bundle all the rest of the rounds and share them all at once to finish the show in one go. So I'll be back with the rest of the results. Okay, in round 3, I found 9 words for 17 points. First up is chela, which means beer.
Dale la chela, wey.
Then alijo, which means stash.
I got a shipment landing next week.
Then we had carnal, which is used for friend.
You know all the bells you want, carnal.
Then is the word encubierto, which means undercover.
Chico over here keeps saying he's working undercover for him.
Then we have algarete, which means to help.
6 months of undercover work down the drain because of those guys.
Then was the phrase estar al tiro. I'm not exactly sure what this one means, but I think it means to be ready. So this is one that I'll drop in the comments for the extra 2 points. Then was the word niñera, which means babysitter.
Ah, chinga. Que este no era la niñera del hijo del gobernador.
Then we have pitazo, which means whistle.
Pudo haber dado el pitazo, eh?
Then was apechugar, which means to take on, or to put up with, or to face.
Ir a comprar mota Durango y apechugar, en serio. Otra vez.
In round 4, we had 7 words for 13 points. Rapid fire, they were bufido for snort, the sound that people make. Then calandria, which is a type of bird. Then gorrioncillo, which means sparrow.
Hasta que un gorrioncillo.
Then alambres, which are wires.
Los alambres rompió.
Then manzano, which is an apple tree. Then coladera, which means a fishery where people fish.
Pero para matar a la rata, supongo que hay que meterse a la coladera.
And then broncón, which I'm not sure what it means either, but I think it means mess, and I will be dropping this one in the comments as well for the extra 2 points.
Después del broncón que nos pasó allá en Sinaloa.
In round 5, I got 3 words for 5 points. We had escarbar for dig.
Más que hay que escarbarle.
And then gordiflón and culero, which I'll put up on the screen.
Vamos a este gordiflón saliéndose de la ciudad.
Finally, round 6, we got 2 words and 6 points. First was hacerse de rogar, which means to play hard to get.
Se hace el rogar.
And then zafado, which means crazy.
De qué manera estás bien zafado.
I hope you enjoyed the video and had fun learning new words while watching and playing along with your favorite show. And throw in the comments what your final score was, as well as any of those 5 to 7 point words that you couldn't find, and see if you can respond to anyone else's comments. And if you see anyone else's words in the comments that you know, give a response up and figure it out. And let us know if we should play this game with any other interesting shows. So not bad. Out of the more than 2,250 words in this episode, we learned about 37 new words and got 63 points. Sending good vibes and energy to you all, and hasta la próxima.